That's right, we're doing a review. Huge thank you to Huion for sending me their Inspirigiano wireless tablet to review. I'm super excited to test this thing out for both drawing and 3D sculpting. So I'm gonna try it with Clip Studio Paint for 2D and with Blender for sculpting in 3D. Did I mention that it's wireless? Do you mean to tell me that Huion wired this less?
Unboxing.
All right, let's open this thing up and see what's inside, shall we? Let's look at what's in the box. First, the pen tablet itself, which is actually huge and surprisingly light. Next is the battery-free pen with its two configurable buttons. Then the charging and connecting cable, which at about 5 feet long is really easy to position. Next is a pen stand, which contains plenty of replacement nibs. I've been using my Huion Canvas for a few years and still haven't worn out the very first nib, so they'll last a while. Finally, there's a quick start guide that'll help you configure your device and get it up and running. Since I already had the Huion driver installed for my canvas, I didn't need to reinstall it, but here's the process anyway. Navigate to www.huion.com/download, then type in Giano and find it in the list. Then just download the driver for your operating system. Once you have the driver installed and you've connected the Giano either with the cable or wirelessly via Bluetooth, the driver screen will look like this, and you can configure all your buttons, working area, and preferences here. The first thing for me to do was to make some preliminary lines in Clip Studio Paint, which felt great. There's actually a very satisfying paper-like texture to the surface of the Giano that gives really nice tactile feedback. Pressure response is exactly what you'd expect, and I didn't have to do any calibration or anything, it worked right out of the box. But I wanted to test out the wireless, to see how far away it would work, to see if there was any lag or loss of precision, and that kind of stuff. So instead of diving in, I left it to charge overnight. The Giano takes 4.5 hours to charge to full, so it's a good idea to plug it in before bed, but a full charge will last around 18 hours, which is more than 2 8-hour days of use. That's kind of nuts. When I got up the next day, it was time to test out the wireless to check any issues like lag. The Giano connected to my PC's Bluetooth without any issues. I unplugged it and then tested it in the office. Then I took it into the living room and there were no lag or pressure issues at all, as you can see here. Alright, now let's put it to work. Not bad for just hopping into a design with no direction. It's not a masterpiece by any means, but the point is, it felt really good to draw. The pen pressure behaved exactly the way I want it to, and the paper texture feels really good to draw on. It's kind of weird, but it adds a lot to the experience. Before I hop into Blender, I'm going to quickly set up some profiles in the Huion driver. This just lets me easily switch between key bindings on the tablet and the pen. I'll set one up for Blender, since I'll be using that next. All I'm going to change here is to set the top pen button to middle mouse and the bottom pen button to left click, because these are helpful for navigating in Blender. I'll set up a profile for Clip Studio Paint as well, since I'm already here, but in this case, I'll keep the default bindings. You may have noticed that I'm not really using the side buttons. That's just a product of my workflow. I rely heavily on keyboard shortcuts for productivity, so I use my regular keyboard for Blender, and my one-handed keyboard for Clip Studio Paint. I did test the side buttons though, and they work exactly as intended, with some nice tactile signals to help you navigate them without needing to look at them. Now that I've got a profile set up for Blender, let's give sculpting a try. tablet felt great for sculpting in Blender, with plenty of accuracy and pressure control, and just as I was getting into the swing of the sculpt, Blender crashed. The one time I didn't save. But here's an example of tablet pressure and accuracy while drawing a mask in Blender. It's very good. Let's talk about the pros and cons of the Inspiroid Giano. Pros: long battery life. 18 hours without needing a charge is a good long time. Huge drawing surface. At 13.6 by 8.5 inches, I couldn't find anything remotely this size for the price. Feels great to draw. Between the excellent pressure performance and the paper-like texture, it's just fun to use. Easy setup. I literally connected this to my PC with two clicks, and then it just worked. I didn't need to calibrate anything at all. Wireless. The Bluetooth connects to different devices and works over a large distance. Price. Coming in at $250 Canadian, when compared to other tablets of a similar size and function, the Giano is a clear winner in terms of price. I couldn't find any other tablets at the same size for a lower price, and all of the tablets I found that were the same price were both smaller and wired. If I were shopping for a pen tablet right now and I didn't want a pen display, the Giano would be my pick. Cons. For me, the Giano is best when you have either a wireless keyboard or a phone companion app for your digital software. The six side buttons are useful for sure, but you can only perform so many functions with six buttons, unless you manually input some complex key bindings into your painting software. As someone who relies on keyboard shortcuts for productivity, the usefulness of a wireless tablet is best for, say, sketching or things that don't require a lot of polish. It is nice to be able to move the tablet around freely though, and especially to be able to connect it to my phone.
Bottom line.
Is Huion's Inspiroid Giano worth it? Yes. It vastly outcompetes in terms of size and functionality for its price, and it feels great to use. Special thanks to Connie at Huion, who is delightful to speak with and who helped me along in this process. Thanks also to everyone who supports this channel. It really means the world to me. I'll see you soon. Deuces.